Welcome back to Let's Play Dragon's Crown! I got my shit pushed in last episode, cause I believe that's the final boss! And something I wasn't all that prepared for. That said, I did a couple quests here. What was this one? Mysterious Whispers. It was a hidden room to the old capital, Route A. After the fish and past the door, you see there's this kind of out of place a little bit, but you might miss it if you're not particularly looking for it. Like this blank wall, you just click on that and it's like the announcer would be like, "You can hear faint whispers past this wall." Perhaps, you know, and then you just hit it to break it, and then you open the chest and we get this. So that quest was done. What else did I get? Still in the depths. This you have to intentionally fuck up the boat ride and get it wrecked to get this. Pretty simple enough in the Pirate's Cove. Scylla. Wrecked you with Alucard in Symphony of the Night. Sucks to be that guy. Hell Evangelist, I had to get this. Route Blue Forgotten Sanctuary, hello. Open the blue door with the skeleton key and then the skeleton key. And then you hit the die spell. I shut this off actually. Sorry, I'm trying to remember everything. Don't want to miss anything. So they were kind of outcasts because anybody with the name Hell Evangelists. It's like a fucking biker king more than a witcher cult. I got those two already. Dead swordsman I got already. Arachne. Yep, just touch that spindle on the spinning wheel in that one round. I showed you that as well. That's easy enough. Yeah, Tale of Arachne if you already are familiar with your mythology. During the bottom spinner punish her for her conceit. Amazon hunters. Yes, I got a court. Wow. Yeah, just killing 50 orcs, and Amazons are like, damn. This guy kicks ass. We welcome you. Are they doing limbo? How low do they go? Anyway, I picked up a couple of trophies doing those, the art things, and because he has 9 bags, I had 9 in 9 areas each. I could switch in between each one, do a couple of those to kind of build up my level. Unfortunately, I was already pretty close to the max for normal, which is 35, where I'm at now. A lot of people here are 34. There we go. Let's get a better look at that opening up.
It's the rune you needed. The 3 special runes react with each other and connect to the illusionary lands.
So, yeah. Which sucks because I had a really good 36, 37, stuff like that, so obviously my adventure does not end here. Let me, here we go. Okay, shit really gets bad and I lose all these guys, I'll use my money to bring them back. Get the potions and everything. I think I need to hang up here to get at this. Here he comes. Ladies and gents, up here. You can't hit me from up here, right? Maybe this is the strategy. Maybe it could have been just me just jumping around or whatever. That would take too long. Oh, there's my what you call it. Give me that. So I'm gonna do the bulk of my damage. No attack. I'm gonna do that. Get up here, please. Before you all dip it. Okay, doing better. Oh, that counts. Oh, so does that, really? Drink up. Shit, there's some fallback on that. Shit, where am I? It's about to do something, get up here. This probably would have been better if I had, like, whatcha calls. Was about to do something. Oh no, it's doing that. Get back up. Back up, back up, back up. You're trying to get me from up here, motherfucker. Uh-oh. People I can throw. Oh shit. That's the nuke the field kind of attack. He's got a lot of those. Alright, plan B. Now what? He's heading up here. He's gonna start dropping shit. Okay. Just jump those, I guess. Oh, you might want to dodge down there. As I'm waiting. Have another push. Wait, is it busting up my Watcher Cults and I can't get him? Oh shit, he's coming back, isn't he? Up here, back up, back up, back up. If this fight takes too long, you bust them up and then you don't have them anymore. It's like a race against time. Back to throwing shit at things. Uh-oh, he's doing that again, back up. Look, I can hit him from afar. Shit, none of those landed. Bullshit. I'm a perfect head level, shit. Uh-oh. Oh no. Drink up. They don't did me there. Oh shit, did they die for real? Oh shit. Oh yeah, that's right, they don't get to come back. Well, so much for them, I'm gonna have to get more. The motor or something. Shit, I probably should have came by myself then if I knew. Forgot all about that shit. That's my fault again. I got scared. I needed backup. That and this fight might take even longer if it's just me. As epic as that would have been. Just a single dwarf against this fucking behemoth. Good swerve, by the way, on giving me a dragon to, before a dragon to fight, too. Well played, clerk. Get the fuck out of there. Am I supposed to take it like that? Oh, I still got burned. Maybe I'm supposed to hide underneath. Ah, oh, come on. Damn it. He's almost down, though. Lost all three of my party, though. Oh, shit. That's exactly what he was doing. Oh, shit. Ah, oh, shit. He's gonna... Wait, I can knock shit back at him? Is that what we're doing? See, that's gonna fuck me up here. Because I timed this right. Whee! Oh, he knocked me right out of it. Ah, there we go.
With a ground-shaking thud,
yeah.
The clouds, the ancient dragon falls. You have returned it to its eternal sleep. The immortal dragon slumbers once again. Congratulations, hero. With your own hands, you have defeated a myth.
That's cool. Look at that fucking insignia. Just hang that on my fucking wall and just be like, it was you. Yes, it was I. I've done my fit. Oh, God. Check out that fucking hand. How many of those can I not equip right now unless I change difficulties? See, I don't even level up right now. I'm stuck at the 35. I got points for doing the quest, but...
The dragon's crown lay near the ancient dragon. It was the cause of this incident, but you can make it a symbol of hope. Without the demons, this is just an ordinary crown. However, the minds of the people have ascribed great power to it.
See, look at this, 38, and triple digit attack, too! There's a 35 I can grab, God. But with only two, let's sell that. Everything else I'm gonna take, looks like. So I'm level 36, but I can't. Okay, I can sell that one. Four. Again, I have 9 bags, so... the slots for all of those things, eventually.
You kneel to offer the dragon's crown to the new queen, Vivian. The crown of the Elysian king fits her well. With the legendary crown, the royal scepter, and orb, none can deny her rightful ascension to the throne. The dragon's crown will be a symbol of power, inspiring fear in the hearts of any who would threaten Highland. It represents the fact that warriors who defeated the mightiest foes reside in Highland, and will rise to defend it from any threat.
Well, why does she get the crown?
Queen Vivian invites you to work at the castle. You value your freedom, so you politely decline.
Oh no, sir. We prefer things our own way.
However, you vow to work for the Queen whenever the need may arise. In turn, she blesses you with the royal favor for life.
I must become king by my own hand.
As you exit through the Great Gate, many soldiers turn and salute. You have completed a legendary accomplishment. Queen Vivian would lead Highland well, reclaiming its past borders and reasserting itself as a powerful nation.
Wow.
The tale of the Dragon's Crown ends here. Despite accomplishing enough for myriad lifetimes, your story is just beginning.
Oh yeah. You added a whole bunch of shit after the fact.
The dwarves had once built a great kingdom underground. Now, the few surviving dwarves lived banded together in small villages.
Oh, so that's what happened. We were... Ooh.
They were nearly exterminated by the ancient dragon, and the underground kingdom became his.
Oh, so we did this for... Oh, so it's the perfect revenge then. Awesome.
The dwarves dub you the Noble Avenger and convey heroic status upon you. Your words are given incredible weight. Dwarves drink with you and dream of a great and powerful nation led by the Noble Avenger.
I'd say I did the name Brigand proud then.
Their hopes are rightly placed, as you will eventually lead them to glory, your name echoing throughout the halls of time.
Now that Brigand was a dwarf, maybe he's just very large for us. Yeah. And now we get this. This looks like a dungeon crawler now, like going through here, like, thank you so much again, Kamitani. I'm thanking you guys. I was, of course, thanking you for watching all of this. Wow. I know I could show off more. I don't want to end it here, because this is a pretty short for now. I was looking at that. I'm like, wait, that's the whatchacallit. I'm like, huh. Maybe it's like... It's alright, I went back, I did the 9 levels, back to back to back to back. You just, if you're gonna do it that way, you can just take the gate. And you'll get a trophy for doing that. It's like, I forget what's it called. Can I have it written down? Insatiable Adventure, it's called. You clear all 9 different levels without returning to town. You just keep continuing, just kept building up, points and coinage and stuff like that. And I just came back with, like, a haul of, like, all these S's. It's got another haul here after beating the dragon. Kind of sucks I lost my 34s just because they don't have... The AI lacks the fortitude to be like, get out of the fucking way. I'm kind of curious now. I know Vanillaware did a... kind of a strategy game for the PS2 can't remember what it's called off the top of my head, but that was like before Odin Sphere even. They did that game, I believe. I only found out Odin Sphere through, I think, KZX was it that first streamed that and showed that off in a stream or something. Somebody streamed it and I looked at it and I was like, what is this game? I must have this. I must play this for myself. That was the turning point for Vanilla where I did this. When I had a Wii, I played Muramasa. I never figured out how PS TV works on Maybe now that's easier with the Watcher card, I might do that because I got the remake for that. I have a couple of Vita games for that reason. I love VS4 would just be like, hey, we can just play them on this thing or whatever, but I think they're like Watcher card based or something like that. But yeah, this game was amazing. I, again, only put it down because of I was doing like LPs at the time and I'm like, I don't have time for this. So I felt really good being like, ah, oh, someday I'll come back to this and be like, yeah. I was hoping for more shit to fly out at me instead of the bats or just kind of... Is this me heading out of Hydland or something like that? And of course, going through that, looking at that, the ending there with the dwarves, I'm thinking like, okay, each character has their own ending now. Probably a trophy for doing so. Oh yeah, I saw at the bottom the gallery. It's like, finish the game with this character. That might be a little tough to do with a couple of them more than others. Maybe it's the elf I can just hang out, shoot arrows. Nah, eventually I gotta come down and kick it to get more. I don't know. I won't bring anybody in. I want to see if I can do it one-on-one. Just gotta remember to bring in, like, whatchacults. I might have been able to do it on my own, just hang about and built up my bombs or whatever, because I have, like, I built up my throw, but it's not going to work on bosses. I need to build up the other thing, which is powder mastery, which all, like, your fire and incendiary attacks do more damage as a result. And I got, like, the unarmed attacks and stuff like that. I also keep forgetting I have the circle button, but, you know, against something like that, you don't want to stay still for long and do that, because then you got to go down and get your weapon. But it would do like 4 lightning bolts. I have it at some point. It would do like crazy damage. Like I practically two-shotted. Even at my level now, it was just cut right through. Like the vampires were nothing. The harpy was nothing. Even Medusa, which was like barely a level above the harpy, got like two-shotted with the lightning on top of all the other damage I was doing at the time. Just flying through it and dropping bombs and all that stuff. Again, he's to me the best character, just because he's just all out in damage. He's not really good on bosses, but then you're like, oh wait, he's the only one that can pick up that rock and throw it. So he has a kind of an advantage on that as well. I don't know why they made him like the... He's like the be-all damage dealer. If you need something killed quickly, you can just grab him and throw him. In my playing of the other characters, I really like how the fighter is... Basically the tank, he can hold people together with his defense. He's got stuff where it's like he'll sacrifice his health to help other people out. Amazon's all about the damage and getting berserk and like doing damage over and over again repeatedly with the frenzy and stuff like that. I thought that the dwarf has it too, but I think she like excels at it because she'll build up her watcher god with him. I gotta remember to do the pump up so he can take like less damage or something like that. He can like bulk himself up. The spellcasters are pretty good, but I tend to favor the flame-based weapons over the lightning. Depends on the enemy. Ice is good, too. Fire does, like, onset damage. Just gotta be careful in water. Otherwise, it'll take it out. And like I said, the elf's, like, bottom tier just because she's so dependent on the arrows and whatnot.
When you glance up at the goddess statue, you notice that the image of Althena has been made anew.
Oh, they fixed it.
When you touch it, the goddess's voice echoes in your head. Her power returned because you defeated the dragon who stole it.
Oh.
Althena praises you and reveals a shocking truth. The ancient dragon you defeated was not the only one that awakened.
Of course.
She wishes that you would also save Jula and Vernus.
You have two statues, okay.
With the goddess's combined powers, the seal will become stronger. They'd be able to seal the gate room permanently, forever locking the ancient dragons in the illusionary lands.
Ancient dragons?
First, you must defeat the ancient dragon who has stolen the goddess Jula's powers. To accomplish this, you must gather 9 more talismans. The trials to claim these will be even more difficult.
Are they the same as before, or...?
These other ancient dragons have been awakened for much longer than the first. They will be far more formidable.
Difficulty has been increased to hard. Maximum level is now 65. So another 30 levels for me to bulk up to. I thought it was just going to be like New Game Plus or something like that, but wow. You go to the Colosseum from the gate. Labyrinth of Chaos from the stables.
Gather the 9 talismans to weaken the dragon, and then defeat it to restore power to the goddess Jula.
I picked up Bones in the Watcher card.
What troubles
you, somebody really
child?
Good. A fellow 36 dwarf, eh?
Lucane seems ecstatic to see you again. The two of you laugh heartily, and you relate what the goddess Althena told you. Lucane muses that you must have been born under interesting stars. No one has spoken to the goddesses since King Elysia. The two of you talk at length. Lucane fires off questions and proposes hypotheses. By the time he is finished, it is dawn.
How can I help you? Which one?
Oh. Oh, they make you buy the Narration Dwarf even though it was a free DLC, so... No? Guess that's the Witcher Cup they give you for... Fucking meteorite scrolls. Got new items, though. Venom Ring, Vortex Scroll. So what's back at the other shop? She didn't say anything new. Hang on. What new stuff do you have? Elixir. That could have been useful. Restock 9. Is it only one use to restock amount? What you got? I still don't get the whole use restock or whatever. Okay, it's 7-6. Maybe it takes from that restock number. Like, it's like a finite use and then you gotta get new ones. That would make sense because you keep getting them all the time.
You're back.
I don't have points. I bet you got new quests, though.
There's a request.
Holy shit! Give me a fucking laundry list. This is probably the rest of them. Harpies in the ancient ruins. Defeat the harpy without destroying the nest. Okay, so a careful touch for an easy boss I could body super quickly. Then again, they might have changed the whatchacallits again. 12 eggs dropped by female wyverns. Now see, this is something I have to fight the boss, but I can't go after it. I have to go after what it summons, is what I'm assuming that is. Are these all boss related? Smash 5 Doom Beetle cocoons? Yeah, it looks like it. Rescue the children. Beat the Minotaur in 2 minutes. Shouldn't be too hard. Where's the Wake at Night? Save the girls and protect them from vampires? Does that... count as me just getting them and keeping them alive, or if they get attacked, I fuck up. Use the magic lamp to call the genie 3 times. That's pretty simple. I bet you've done that in the actual fight, I shun you. The golem ruins. Ooh! I have to beat it. Oh, that might be... that might take a while. Destroying the golem without activating any runes, so I can't use my golem to get at him. Oh shit. So that the runes may be deciphered. You cannot touch the runes while taking it. Yeah. Peer into the past. What's that, though? What's his name? Defeat the warlock. Solo. Okay. Equip and earn and beat the gazer solo. 10 gladiators. That's probably the guys who like the swords and shields, I'm assuming. Crush Highland's enemies. Midsummer and... oh, one more Midsummer Days request. 10 fairies in various cages in various locations. Okay, that's a overtime winter call, so let's grab that real quick. And am I not done yet at all? I'll probably get to level 65 just getting all these. I still haven't figured out these 3 yet, though. Young Sea Serpent in the Shallower is a ghost ship cove. The Catacombs, I don't know... what even the ghost is if I'm gonna turn clockwise. Now, what does it mean by dance? Do I just, like, move back and forth while I'm doing it or something? Can I do that? False God statue. I might have to look some of these up. Because I... I could find it on my own, A, B, and C. If I can't find anything, I'll be like, this quest so-and-so.
You go to Queen Vivian and ask if there is anything you can assist her with. There are still some problems in the region.
Barbarian subterranean forest? Oops.
Skirmishes have broken out along much of the nation's borders. If you could quell them, she would feel very relieved.
Oh. Should I take that on first and she does something different? Did she just point me in a random special location? Anyway, the goat said it could take me to the one place and then there's something else. Okay, that's the Colosseum. Battle other players here by using the network. Oh. And it doesn't fuck up my whatchacallit. Can I one player it? That might only be multiplayer then. Hmm. Does the gate still take me to shit randomly? I'm gonna assume yes. Let me. Because I want to see the other place. They said I can only access the other place through the stables, right? The Labyrinth of Souls or whatever the frig that place is. Labyrinth of Chaos. Wow, it just takes me right here. Target Bill Baron Subterranean Fortress? It's telling me to go there. Okay. Alright, they up shit. At least they tell you what they are. If we do the 60. Nearly 141. Any of these doable right now? 40, 50. Well, they said I could change it to easy. Does that mean the levels drop as well? And I can't, I mean, I don't want to do that. It'd be at least 40 to match them, though. That's the weakest one. I don't know. I guess maybe I'll just show up the Labyrinth of Chaos just for something new right now. Maybe this is doable right now? Of course, I tried that with the dragon last time and got bodied. Ooh, okay. Hmm. So I can get shit from doing those. Probably super rare stuff, too. It's just floor one, right? Oh, it says 1-1. I don't know how many rooms in that floor. Oh! You just dropped me in randomly. Game spiders! Look away from the poison. They're not too tough so far. Oh, someone else joined. Are you a high level or a low level? Alright, pressing on. Oh, now we're in a completely different room altogether. Okay, so that's just like random shit? Wait, there's a rock. Boss? Nope. We'll definitely use this boulder to make my job even- Ooh, on the catch, baby! Go moan and slam, and welcome to the- Fuck you! God damn it! I'm dodging my throws, man. It's because you're low center of gravity. Thank you! There we go. That one's easier to grab. I can also grab them too, but... Uh-oh. Those traps as well? Oh, they count as damage too. You're already biffing it too. Give me that boulder. Look out for traps! Oh, shit! Keep prepared down here. More than I can say for myself. Shit, that does count as what you call it. Get away from that. Damn, I should have saved that for you. We already revived. that. Oh my god, guys. I killed my goddamn wizard. Maybe I was meant to come down here with higher levels. Another one else joined me. Oh, by the way, them little creepy skeletons, they're the doppelgangers I've been trying to fight before. I used to see them because they're always in the fucking dark room where the whatchacallit is in the lab. Mage's Tower. This? Does this hold up every once in a while? Is it? Okay, you got him then. Wait to see if this is actually can be broken. Like, you've used this enough times. Also, I can't take it with me. Shite. Bombs away! Bombs away! Get the fuck on. See, that's a double one. Get out of here. Grab the food. Why don't y'all grab this up here? Okay, moving on. Get your ass down. Shit, there's oil down here. There's another ride over there. We ride! Actually, you ride, I don't know about it. Some crystals down here. Well, one of y'all take it. Come on. That was money, people. I'm just gonna grab him and throw him. Looks like the enemies are retaining mostly the same whatchacallits. Either that or I'm just doing that much damage with my 35. Not to make a difference. Unless this starts getting crazier later beforehand. This looks like a boss room. Fight the Medusa again. Yeah, there we go. Medusa-lair. Now, do I fight one boss or several? It's like just all for like the one floor. It might be just the same areas with different difficulties, so I don't know what else to... Can show off? I don't know. I don't know if anything is new in this game. Otherwise, I think this is I can call this a finale. I mean, I'll do the other shit, but it might be just stuff I do on my own time if nothing's super vastly different. I don't know. What do you guys think? People who've played this game will probably be able to let me know. Or I could always look it up myself. Alright, I got her. I'm always weirded out because she, like, delayed kill because she's got, like, oh, I'm dead. I have to turn to stone and fall away now. All that was 1-1. Shit. They gave me a 2B, so I doubt that's the, whatchacallit. Wish for a further challenge, continue your adventure, or return to... If I continue, where does that put me? Yeah, I was afraid of that 1-2.
They're here.
There's the fucking doppelganger. They leap on you and then they turn into that character and become a pain in the ass. See, there's another wizard out there. I was attacking me in the earlier area. I shouldn't have continued. I forgot he was almost already down. How deep do these floors go, by the way? It could be like, is anywhere from like 1-3 or to 1-20 or some shit. You know what I mean? Or maybe it's like 1-9. Maybe it does all the rooms and then like... now you gotta do the second floor, and now everything's like 5-10 levels higher or some shit, you know what I mean? I wish it told me beforehand, before I came down here. But maybe that's the way of the game trying to surprise me still. Then again, the rooms are random. The levels might be too, or like at least a ballpark number. I think I need heavier dudes for to come down here and further. I want that whatchacallit at the end, but I don't want to. Then again, I'm gonna go through all the whatchacallits and just be like, hey, just do this one room, and oh, here's this level 50 guy I have now. Here's this level 55. Yeah. If I bulked up, so did they. All I've gotten so far was level 34s. So I brought in to fight the dragon. I got the 35 from the bones of the guy with the dragon. I haven't gotten any bones down here, so yeah. I'm willing to bet I need to do it that way first. What the fuck's going on? Where am I? Oh, I turned into a frog. Shit. An Odin Sphere bullshit all over again. It's the transformation to take forever. Fucking day and a half to get there, but now I'm slowed for some reason. Is the wizard doing that? Hold on. You folks, dude, get out of here. Goddamn army of frogs over here. Oh, you biffed it. Come here. You stop spazzing all over the place and stand still. She's almost dead too. She got most of her life still though. Getting mad if I can barely keep hordes contained like that, shit. Then again, I was a frog for half of that. By the way, the gazer can do that, and the gazer is a pain in the fucking ass to do with spellcasters, because as a beholder, as a gazer or something like that, they have this innate thing of, like, magic nullification. So, they actually need to bring people in to do most of their damage, otherwise they're going to have to stand still and hit the and mash the square button to do your damage, which is ill-advised, by the way, if you're a spellcaster or sorceress. You're not gonna get close with those characters. Elf in the same boat, but she's got arrows and shit. See, any magic is just done with. Sucks I can't take the boulder with me. I would use it all the fucking time. Where's the Minotaur? Got this account as I'm killing it in 2 minutes. Let's see. I think I gotta do it in the Watcher Call anyway. And he's got backup too, shit. Just more shit to throw. Charging. There she goes. Away that. My Watcher Call. Where's me boulder? Like this. Just dodging. This. Grab the dudes. I got food or something like that to help. Damn, I barely survived that. Death from above. Let's get that off before I die. No damage, everything. Stomp on the ground. Of all things. I'm trying to dodge him. Am I back yet? Slam dunk, bitch! Boom! The bombs. Should die now, shit. Close enough. I hit that too, it keeps knocking me out of shit. Whoa, it's fast. This fucker sped up! Or he just has more command now that he's low on health. You were not this fast before. Oh, gotta kill him quickly. Gotta kill him quickly. There we go. So I don't lose those two. Because I'm getting the fuck out of here. I wonder if it continues later, if I can... Nah, I don't think that would make sense. They wouldn't give me 9 bags of shit to buy and then be like, hey, you can come, you can start from this here now. It's got to be like to complete the entire floor if you want to do the shit like that. So, back to town. Take the spoils, take the money, and run. Alright. Alright. Leveling a 3/4. Yeah, can't hate on that. I'm level 36 now. I can equip better shit now for everybody. Level 35 for you later with 5 Watch of Cults. Praise that. Alright, the princess told me to come here. I don't know what to expect different from this place, but I'm gonna tackle this with my level 36 and a level 41 area and see how well I do. Like I said, I grabbed a bunch of next level shit I could have thrown on myself. I'm not killing these in one hit now. Oh good, it was that. I was afraid I was gonna have to do rank B and that wouldn't count. I didn't see anything different. I just fought the Minotaur again.
Vivian gives you a reward. She thanks you from the bottom of her heart for supporting her from the shadows like this.
Maybe it's just for bonus money.
You feel a great sense of pride and hope your assistance can make a difference to the remarkable queen. You go to Queen Vivian and ask if there is anything you...
Yep, now she points me to the underground labyrinth. This is how we get extra money. Okay, well... Might be a short finale, but that was Dragon's Crown. Take care. Thanks for watching. Next LP. I think I have another. I think I like this dragon motif. I think I'm gonna keep it. So next LP will have Dragon it too in the title. That's the only clue you're getting. So until then, take care. Thanks for watching.